Hello, beautiful souls. Before I begin today, I just wanted to extend a thank you to all of you because I know that the videos have been delayed coming out, but it seems to be out of my hands, so I trust all is happening exactly as it's supposed to, and I'm going to continue forward with the lessons every day and record one every day, even if they don't get uploaded every day. But they all will be in perfect time. So with that being said, today we are on lesson 96. Salvation comes from my one self. My one self. Salvation comes from my one self. So here we go through the lesson today. Although you are one self, you experience yourself as two, as both good and evil, loving and hating, mind and body. This sense of being is split into opposites, induces feelings of acute and constant conflict, and leads to frantic attempts to reconcile the contradictory aspects of this self-perception. You have sought many such solutions, and none of them have worked. The opposites you see in you will never be compatible, but one exists. Wow, this is quite potent right off the bat. Only one self exists, not a mind and a body, or a good and a bad, or a loving and a hating, but only one exists. The other is made up by our mind. So let's keep going. The fact that the truth and the illusion cannot be reconciled no matter how you try, what means you use, and where you see the problem, must be accepted if you would be saved. So the fact that truth and illusion cannot come together and they cannot be reconciled is what we must recognize before we can be saved. Until you have accepted this, you will attempt endless lists of goals you cannot reach, a senseless series of expenditures of time and effort, hopefulness and doubt. Each one is futile as the one before and failing as the next one surely will. Right? So we constantly look for all the ways that can save us by trying to bring the mind and the body together and follow all our own separate goals as well as the one goal that's been given us for us to be saved. And those two ways of being will never work together. Problems that have no meaning cannot be resolved within the framework they are set. That's much like what Einstein has said many times, and I've used this many times. We cannot solve a problem with the same level of consciousness that created it. That's exactly what it's saying here. Problems that have no meaning cannot be resolved within the framework they are set. Two selves in conflict could not be resolved, and good and evil have no meaning place. Good and evil have no meaning place. They come from totally opposite levels of consciousness that do not come together. The self you made can never be yourself, capital S. Nor can yourself, capital S, be split into two and still be what it is and must forever be. And I feel that this is why the question is always seemingly unanswered in this world. What am I? Because we're identifying with two selves, both minds, both good and evil, whereas only one is our reality. There is only one self. So we're coming to this point today to accept this and experience this truth for ourselves. The mind and the body cannot both exist. Make no attempt to reconcile the two. For one denies the other can be real. If you are physical, your mind is gone from your self-concept, for it has no place in which it could be really part of you. If you are spirit, then the body must be meaningless to your reality. So either we are a spirit or a body. We cannot be both, even in this time-space continuum. This time-space continuum is but a dream that we are experiencing together. And this dream is a dream that we could possibly be these bodies. So if we're identifying both with a body and a spirit, then we are not identified with our true self, and we will constantly experience the conflict that comes from two identities that we are trying to accept as being what we are. But there is only one self. Spirit makes use of mind as means to find its self-expression. And the mind, which serves the spirit, is at peace and filled with joy. Its power comes from spirit, and it is fulfilling happily its function here. Yet mind can also see itself divorced from spirit and perceive itself within a body it confuses with itself. Without its function, then, it has no peace, and happiness is alien to its thoughts. So again, we're seeing here that the mind could be in service of the soul, of the spirit, and when the mind is in service of the spirit, that's when we are in complete peace and absolute joy, fulfilling our function effortlessly. But when our mind is in service, or in part service to the body, then that is where the conflict resides. That when we have these goals that are trying to sustain the body in the physical form, as well as these goals that have given us to our spirit by God, then we are conflicted, trying to combine two levels of consciousness together, and that is never, ever, 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 ever going to work. And we've seen that ever, 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 ever going to work. Ever. Never. And so it keeps going. Yet mind apart from spirit cannot think. This is what we've been realizing. These thoughts are meaningless in my mind. The mind that is apart from spirit, that identifies with the body, cannot think. It just accepts. It has denied its source of strength, and it sees itself as helpless, limited, and weak. Disassociated from its function now, it thinks it is alone, separate, attacked by armies, massed against itself, and hiding in the body's frail support. Now must it reconcile unlike with like, for this is what it thinks that it is for. So now, the physical body and the mind that is perceiving itself as this body that looks out into the world and sees war and feels itself to be weak and confined to this form, that is where it is going to try and say, I like this, I don't like that. I like this, I don't like that. And it's going to make judgment based on a false perception, based on false thinking, based on a false self. This is where all confusion and conflict lies. Jesus says clearly, waste no more time on this. Who can resolve the senseless conflicts which a dream presents? Exactly. These wars and infiltrations of craziness and chaos is what the dream is presenting, not reality. Okay? So who can resolve the senseless conflicts which a dream presents? What could the resolution mean in truth? What purpose could it serve? What is it for? My favorite question. What is it for? Salvation cannot make illusions real and solve a problem that does not exist. Perhaps you hope it can. Yet would you have God's plan for the release of his dear son bring pain to him and fail to set him free? Exactly. Exactly. Yourself, capital S, retains its thoughts. And they remain within your mind and in the mind of God. That's why these are thoughts that we share, because they always remain in the mind that we share with God, and it is our true mind. The Holy Spirit holds salvation in your mind and offers it the way to peace. Salvation is a thought you share with God, because His voice accepted it for you and answered in your name that it was done. So the answer is the Holy Spirit. God has given us the Holy Spirit. That means the answer to our problems here in this world has been given us. The answer is salvation. And salvation is an idea. It's a thought, right? Just like God is, just like we are. We are a thought in the mind of God. And so when we accept that salvation is a thought that we share with God, well, then we remember that it is His power that has been given us to save us here. And we must call upon His power that is within us, that is the joint will, the joint power that will allow us to accept salvation for ourselves on behalf of all the world. And the Holy Spirit's already done that and said yes. So all we have to do is say yes. Thus, is salvation kept among your thoughts, your self holds dear and cherishes for you. So it's there, waiting for us to see it. We will attempt today to find this thought, capital S. I mean, thought, capital T. You know, thinking S, salvation. Thought, capital T. Whose presence in your mind is guaranteed by Him who speaks for you from your one self. So we must trust that the Holy Spirit is in my mind, in your mind, in all of our minds, because we are all equal children of God, and therefore all of us can turn within and let the Holy Spirit speak to us and remind us of this thought of salvation. So that is what we're looking for today. That is what we are seeking for today. We don't have to care about all the other meaningless thoughts that we've accepted and what we think we've done and what other people have done. That is irrelevant right now. We're going past all of that to the thought of salvation, which is where our freedom lies. So we will attempt today to find this thought whose presence in your mind is guaranteed by him who speaks to you from your one self. Our hourly 5-minute practicing will be a search for him within your mind. So again, 5-minute practice periods, an hour, and this will be searching our mind for this thought that we share with God. Salvation comes from this one self through him who is the bridge between your mind and it. So that's all we're doing. We're crossing the bridge to timelessness. We're leading out of the world of dreams to the realm of reality. Okay, we're moving from the illusion to the truth today. So Jesus is reminding us, wait patiently and let him speak to you about yourself and what your mind can do, restored to it and free to serve its will. So we don't have to do anything actively today. The only activity that we will be doing is an active listening. So we are going to be listening for spirit within to remind us of this thought of salvation so that we simultaneously can remember that we are free and allow ourselves to fully serve our will, our shared will, which is where our happiness is. So begin the practice period before we wait patiently in our mind and listen. Begin by saying this: salvation comes from my one self. Its thoughts are mine to use. Salvation comes from my one self. Its thoughts are mine to use. Then seek its thoughts and claim them as your own. These are your own real thoughts you have denied, and let your mind go wandering in a world of dreams to find illusions in their place. Here are your thoughts, the only ones you have. Salvation is among them. Find it there. So again, the only true thoughts that we have are the ones we share with God. And so we are going right to the source of it all today. Right to the source of it all today. If you succeed, the thoughts that come to you will tell you you are saved, and that your mind has found the function that it sought to lose. Yourself, capital S, will welcome it and give it peace. Restored in strength, it will again flow out from spirit to the spirit in all things created by spirit itself. Your mind will bless all things. Confusion done. You are restored, for you have found yourself. As we look past our thoughts and find this thought of salvation in our mind, that is what frees us, beautiful souls, and it is already within us. Thank you, God. It is already here. We need not seek outside of it and find it there. It will never be out there. Out there is just the projection. It's a dream. And here is reality. So let's find our truth here and let it transform our entire mind to remind us that we are free, to clear us of all confusion, and let us rest in peace, perfect safety, and sense of fulfillment and purpose. This is for all of us to experience. Yourself, capital S, knows you cannot fail today. Perhaps your mind remains uncertain yet a little while. Be not dismayed by this. The joy yourself experiences, it will save for you, and it will yet be yours in full awareness. Every time you spend 5 minutes of the hour seeking him who joins your mind and self, you offer him another treasure to be kept for you. Each time today you tell your frantic mind salvation comes from your one self, you lay another treasure in your growing store. And all of it is given everyone who asks for it and will accept the gift. Think then, how much is given unto you to give this day that it be given you? Dun dun dun. And so it is. Salvation comes from my one self. beautiful. I am so humbly grateful to be reading these lessons and to have this tool that our brother Jesus has given us to remember the truth about us and to truly claim our part as saviors of the world. Because once we accept the thought of salvation in our mind that is given by spirit to spirit, then it extends to the spirit in all things. Because remember, we are one self. We are not two. We are one self. A bird is a bird, period. A spirit is a spirit, period. And so we are. I love you, beautiful souls. Have a blessed day and enjoy today's lesson. Bye.